Ready for action, nip it in the bud, we never relaxing. Outcast is everlasting, not clashing, not at all. But see, my want to do a little acting. Now that's for anyone asking, give me one pass them. Drip, drip, drop, there it goes an orgasm. Now you coming out the side of your face, we tapping right into your memory bank. Saints, so click at the ticket, let's see your seatbelt fastin'. Trunk rattling, like 2 inches in the back seat, wrestling. Speaker box vibrate the tag, make it sound like aluminum cans in a bag. But I know y'all wanted that 808, can you feel that BASS? But I know y'all wanted that 808, can you feel that BASS? Silent. The girls all paused with glee, turning left, turning right, thought they looking at me. Well, I was looking at them, there on the dance floor. Now they got me in the middle, feeling like a man. Especially the big girls need love too. No discrimination in this world. So keep your hands off my cheeks. Let me study how you got to be, you big freak, skinny slim.
All right, what's going on, everybody? This is Martin Ricard from Council 57. I'll be getting started in just a moment, so just give me a few minutes just to get. Just to make sure that everybody is on, and I'll get started.
Them women got the go within them. You can them lift them, bend them, give them something to remember. Yell out timber when you fall through the chop shop. Take a deep breath and exhale. Your ex-male friend, boyfriend, sworn his head. Well, let me listen to the story you tell. And we can make moves like a person in jail. On the low.
I'll be getting started in just one moment, just to make sure everything is working okay for those who are on now. If you can hear me okay, there is a chat feature for the webinar. Just type in Y if you can hear me, and just want to make sure everybody is able to see my screen and follow along. So if you can, if you're hearing everything okay, just type in a Y in the chat, and I'll get started in just a moment. All right, so welcome everybody to tonight's webinar. I'm going to just jump right into this. So I want to start off with a question that I'm sure might be on everybody's mind. And, you know, I know I hear this a lot, and I've even experienced this myself. But, you know, did you know that the most important thing to understand about Facebook is that it's all about sharing the right post at the right time to the right audience? Like, that's what Facebook is really about, right? And the reason I'm posing this question is because I know we've all gotten so used to thinking that Facebook has just become the place to go to hang out online, right? It's like a virtual dinner or office party. And I know some people think that Facebook has just become a place where people share what's really on their minds behind their true identities. And there's some truth to that, right? I believe that what I'm going to point out to you today, it's going to change the way you look at your local school. And just before I get started, let me see. Just want to make sure everybody's able to hear me. What I might do is I might mute all the lines, okay? Awesome. So everybody should still be able to hear me, but I just wanted to make sure that there's no, I just want to make sure everybody hears me clearly. And if there's any questions, feel free to ask them at the end. So again, if everybody can hear me clearly, if you can just type in Y in the chat, just want to make sure everything is clear. Awesome. Awesome. Okay. All right, so just so we're not strangers, I know everybody may not know who I am, so just wanted to let you know that I'm Martin Ricard. I'm the communications specialist for AFSCME Council 57, and I've managed actually dozens of social media pages over my career, and I'm the one who's been leading the effort to increase engagement and fans on the council's social media pages. So let's just jump right into today's topic, which is, what is the best way to post to your local's Facebook page so that you can maximize your time and increase engagement from members and supporters? So what I want to introduce you to is a tool called Action Sprout. I'm not sure if you've ever heard of this. Even if you have before, I just want to introduce this to you because it's a very powerful tool that once you learn how to use this, can actually do a lot of good for your local and for how you manage your social media pages. So Action Sprout is basically a platform that makes it easy for nonprofits to share content on Facebook that people care about and want to be seen sharing. And before I explain how this powerful tool works, what I want to do today is just point out three myths that I want everyone to stop believing about Facebook. And then I want to show you how you can use Action Sprout to be the social media hero your local wants to see. That's why everybody is here tonight. And just before you jump to any conclusions about what works on Facebook or what makes people want to share your content, I just want you to remain open to the fact that basically by incorporating Action Sprout into your local's communication strategy, you're going to start seeing some amazing results. Okay, so here's the first myth that I want everybody to stop believing about what's possible on Facebook. And that myth is, it's nearly impossible to know what to post each day to reach the right people in your community, right? So the big idea here is that on any given day, there's an abundance of content available for you to post on your page. The challenge is really just figuring out what's the best content to post for your page, right? And this is important. This is an important distinction because once you're able to quickly figure out what are the most basically popular articles, videos, and images for topics related to your community on a particular day, so managing a Facebook page will just start to feel like child's play. That's really my whole goal here, is to show you that managing your Facebook page is actually quite simple. And so once you got the right mix of content to choose from, all you have to do is share the most popular, highly engaging content on your own page so that you can reach and engage the most people. And the best part about all this is that Action Sprout does all the heavy lifting so you can focus on posting only the best content. So that's one of the key things I just want to get across. Now, the second myth is this. The second myth that I want everybody to stop believing is this. Making a good Facebook post requires a lot of guesswork. So the main thing to understand here is that, yes, like Facebook's algorithm is always going to be changing. Like we can count on that, right? But there is a way to understand why some posts do well while others don't. And so what Action Sprout has done is they analyze millions of Facebook posts and from that research, they identify what patterns influence more people to leave a reaction, comment, or share on a post. And by giving you access to that information, this tool can help you identify your most engaging posts and how to recreate that success again. So that's, again, why this is just very, very powerful. Now, the third myth that I want everybody to stop believing about Facebook is that figuring out a way to post engaging content on a daily or weekly basis takes a lot of time. That's something I hear a lot. And I know that's it's a valid concern. And hopefully I can just help dispel that myth. And the reason I say that is because, you know, when you post great content, it makes the time factor seem irrelevant. And the best way to consistently post great content is not surprisingly, to start with great content. And this is an important point to understand because what Action Sprout, what they do is that it comes with a feature called inspiration, which I'll show you in just a moment. And that tees up popular trending stories related to the mission of whatever your local stands for in your area, right? And so all you have to do is share those posts on your own Facebook page and add your own commentary if you'd like to start a conversation with your followers. And this is called content curation. And it's actually the secret behind the success of many nonprofit social media pages. So I know what you're probably thinking at this point. You know, it's going to be a challenge for me to learn how to use another tool, right? When I already have so much on my plate. But the tricky thing is that most people still think running a Facebook page is just like having their own personal page. And so, right, so there's a key distinction there. On your personal page, you can post whatever you want, you know, whenever you feel like it. But if you're not intentional with your local's Facebook page, and if you're not tuned into what your audience really cares about, you're going to get disappointed. And I don't want that for anyone. And so that's why I think that this tool called Action Sprout is something that every local can start incorporating into what they're doing. So I don't want to just leave you with all these thoughts, right? I actually want to show you and demonstrate how this works and how you could actually use this on a daily or weekly basis. And then what I'll do is I'll open this up to everybody. So if you have any questions, we can kind of answer those and I can show you some other things if you have that. So if that's cool, I'd like to just show you how this works for the next few minutes. All right. So here's what Action Sprout looks like. This is the homepage. It's called actionsprout.com. You can go on there. It's actually free to sign up. And the way it works is once you sign up, I'll just show you how to do this. Once you sign up for an account, what you're going to do is you're going to link, it links your Facebook page. So you have to have a Facebook account. And then you're able to start using this tool basically almost immediately. What you're able to do is you're able to link your local's Facebook page, right? And so number one, you do have to be the admin for your local's Facebook page. But if you're looking to basically do anything with your local's Facebook page anyway, you should be an admin. And by doing that, you're able to select your local's Facebook page and connect that to Action Sprout. And so I'm going to just show you what the dashboard looks like. And then you'll kind of see what I'm talking about here. And you'll kind of see why this is really powerful than just trying to, you know, operate from your Facebook page alone. So Action Sprout comes with this cool feature called its dashboard. And it gives you kind of like all of these analytics about, you know, how your page is doing and where there are opportunities. The other thing I do want to point out just before I get into any of the features is that if you have designated your local's Facebook page as a nonprofit organization, you can actually get a grant. And so you can actually upgrade this account to like a pro account as a nonprofit. And that allows you basically to add more features to this account. I've actually showed a couple of locals how to do this already, and I've seen some success there. So I just want to point that out real quick. So for example, this is the Council 57 Facebook page, and you'll see the same thing on your locals Facebook page. And under the About tab, you're going to see that you can categorize your local. And I know that some folks might have categorized it differently, but I'm going to give you some tips. So the first thing that you want to do is you want to categorize your page as labor union, right? That's one of the categories in Facebook. However, the second thing you want to categorize your Facebook page as is a nonprofit organization. And so once you do that, then you're able to really start using Action Sprout for its, you know, intended purposes. Okay, so here's what I want to do. So there's a tab in Action Sprout called Inspiration, and this is where you're going to spend most of your time, and this is where this gets really, really powerful. So if you can kind of see on my screen, there's a little section under the Inspiration tab called Followed Pages. This is really, really important. And so under the free account, I believe you can have up to 10 pages that you follow. And again, these are just other Facebook pages, right? So you'll notice that a lot of these are pretty familiar in the labor movement. So for Council 57 as an umbrella organization, some of these just make sense, right? So like, for example, we already follow, you know, the AFL-CIO. We follow the IU. We also follow some other councils that just do a good job on social media. And we follow the Labor Fed. And there's some other pages that are basically, you know, related to working people's issues or just the labor movement in general. What I would recommend is kind of thinking about, you know, what makes sense either for your, you know, local area, you know, because, you know, we represent Northern California for Council 57, and we also represent other parts of California. We all don't think alike. So, you know, you don't have to follow these same pages. However, what I found just in doing this for a while is that, you know, a lot of these pages have really good content that just speak to all kinds of working people's issues. And so the other thing to keep in mind is that these pages have lots and lots of followers already. So you don't want to just pick a page just because you like it or something like that. You want to try to pick a page that already has lots and lots of followers, because this is going to give you a better chance of finding that right type of post to share with your audience. And I'll demonstrate what that looks like. So the whole point, right, of having all of these pages selected is so that you can really speak to your audience's values. Again, it may be a little different than, you know, the council in general, right? Because we're kind of speaking to all of California. In your area, you might just be speaking to, for example, you might just be speaking to folks in Santa Clara County or, you know, Contra Costa County, or you might be speaking to folks in the Central Valley. You can kind of gauge, you know, if there's a you know, different set of values in those areas. However, once you're able to figure that out, then you can go to this Inspiration tab. And what it does is it populates with a whole bunch of posts that you can just select from each and every day. Now, I don't want you to get surprised by any of this when you're seeing this, right? However, what you're seeing is Action Sprout, like I explained earlier, analyzes all the different posts, right? And it kind of rates them and tells you what is the most engaging post and what is likely to be the most engaging post if you share it with your audience. So as you notice, like some of these posts, I probably wouldn't post on our, you know, Council 57 post. I mean, our Council 57 page. However, this just gives me an idea of what others are posting that's related to either working people's issues or, you know, labor stuff, things like that. This kind of lets you know what's on people's minds. and what people are sharing and what they're engaging with, right? So as you kind of scroll through this, you'll notice that, okay, you know, you'll see this green up arrow and a percentage, and it's telling you that, you know, this particular post is performing this amount of percentage above average, right? And so you'll often see that. And then you'll run into something like this, for example, like this AFL CIO post is performing 780% above, you know, average performance. So for example, if you kind of looked at that post and you said, you know what, that is relevant to our audience, and it's already performing really high, you know, it has really high engagement, then that's probably a good post to share on your page. And again, it's not always going to be an exact science, but if you select the right pages, I guarantee you on any particular day, you're going to be able to find a good post that, you know, that really gets your audience engaged. And I'll just give you an example. You know, so if you ever follow the Council 57 Facebook page, this is actually one of the ways that I can tell that something is going to work on that particular day. Okay, let me see if I can find this Yoda one here. I think that was a few days ago. Let's see here. Okay, so like, for example, everybody knows that, you know, I guess the new Star Wars, the new Star Wars movies are starting to come out again, and everybody is fawning over Baby Yoda, right? And so it just so happens that somebody created a meme that's relevant to the labor movement, right? And so they took this photo of Baby Yoda, put a caption on it. This is extremely relevant to what we do in the labor movement. And I kind of knew that this would probably be really engaging. And it turns out that it really was. So this particular post on this particular day got 37 reactions, which is really, really good for a Facebook post. And so that just gives you an idea of how powerful this tool is. And that's pretty much how ActionSprout works. And then the other thing that you can do is that, you know, let's say you want to kind of learn a little bit more about why a particular post did so well. Well, there's also a tab in the dashboard of ActionSprout called Timeline, and it's also tracking your own timeline. So it's tracking the post that you share on your Facebook page, and it's telling you important information. So let me see if it finds that Yoda, the Yoda post. Oh, it's right here, right? So it's showing me that, yes, this got 37 reactions. It even got a comment. And it's also telling me that it's likable, discussable, and engaging. So those are all good factors. Like, if you found other posts like this, it would probably do really well. And then it also tells you, you know, what some of your posts are, or how well some of your posts are doing, and if they're really outperforming all the rest of them. So for example, we posted this post about one of our members who, you know, he got recognized by the Raiders and the Cal football team recently for basically saving a passenger's life. He works at BART. And I mean, we already knew that he went viral, but again, this post went viral on our page as well. So we want to post more things like this in the future. So this is helpful information for somebody who, you know, really wants to make good use out of their Facebook page. All right, so here's what I'm gonna do. There might be some feedback here, but I'm going to open this up to questions. So if you have any questions, feel free to let me know, or feel free to also, you can type them in the chat, all right? So let me do this. All right, so everybody is unmuted, so I'll leave the last few minutes here for questions. So does anybody have a question or a comment? Feel free to let me know. Or like I said, you can also write it in the chat.
Hey, Mark, this is Colin from Local 444. How are you?
How's it going?
Hey, I caught in here a little bit late, just slightly, but I actually have a quick question. I know that you said this was free, Action Sprout, but I was wondering, is there a limit to the free, like how long it's free, or how many users are, what do they actually start charging you for that? I know you were mentioning a couple things about software, like a grant or something like that. I only heard a little bit of that.
Okay, and I think your question was, you're asking how long is Action Sprout free, right?
Yes.
Okay, awesome. Okay, great question. So actually, the good thing about this tool and the reason why I'm sharing this with everybody is because it's free forever, believe it or not. As I mentioned, it is free. And you can, what you can do is you can actually follow up to 10 pages if you just didn't do anything else, right? As I show, let's see if I can still show it here. So as you'll see on this inspiration tab and the follow pages, you can follow a number of pages, right? But it gives you a limit if you just signed up, right? However, you can apply, and I'll show you how to do this. I'll show everybody who wants to how to do this. So you can apply for a grant through the app if you designate your Facebook page as a nonprofit organization. And that makes it free.
Okay.
That makes it free forever. And that also allows you to add more pages so you can get more inspiration, if that makes any sense.
That does make sense. Thank you.
Okay, no problem. All right. Any other questions, feel free to let me know. Again, I know there may be some feedback, but this has been great so far. So let me know what's on your mind.
Martin, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
It's Ryan from 829.
Hey, what's up, Ryan?
I just want to say to the last person too, while you were presenting, I linked our account and we were already set up as a nonprofit, and there was a little tab at the top to apply for the grant, and I clicked the button and it instantaneously applies your grant and you don't have to do anything else. So I already have a control, full access.
That's awesome. Yeah. It's super easy, and they love working with folks like us. So they make it really easy to do that. So I appreciate that. Right on. All right.
Hey, Martin.
Yes, sir.
How you doing? This is Sean.
Hey, what's up, Sean?
I'm doing well, man. Hey, the menu that you have on the side here that says dashboard, stories, timeline, and social actions, etc.
Yes.
Yeah, that.
Okay.
Do those come with the with this program?
Oh, yes, they do. So I didn't really go over these because these are some of the other features that, I mean, you could use all of this, but I'll just give you an example of what this is. So stories, they kind of added this recently, but basically these are kind of like articles that they curate as well.
Okay.
So let's say, for example, like you saw an article in the, I don't know, I'm gonna just make this up, in the San Francisco Chronicle, about, you know, how about how the labor movement is now 50%. Yeah, I'm just making this up, right? And let's say you want to share that article on your Facebook page. So this is kind of like that. Like, they find different articles around the web and they allow you to share this to your page as well. I don't really use this, but, you know, again, you can if you want to. Social actions. This is just another feature where it's kind of like making a petition. You can kind of play around with this. We kind of use another tool called Action Network to do types of petitions. But anyway, if you want to use this, you can play around with it as well. And then people is just the folks who interact with those actions. And like I said, those are kind of the extra features. If you want to use those, that's fine. You have access to them. But I would spend most of my time in that inspiration tab, because all you want to do is you want to curate, for the most part, you want to curate content. Like, you actually shouldn't, you really shouldn't focus that much on producing original posts that much. You kind of want to do that maybe like once, maybe twice a week. And the rest of the time, you can just schedule a bunch of posts that are going to be relevant to your audience, if that makes sense. All right. Hope I didn't lose everybody. Okay. Are there any questions, any more questions, or feel free to type anything else in the chat? I got a few more minutes.
Hey, Martin, this is Dan from 101.
Hey, what's up, Dan?
Okay, so like I was saying earlier, I avoid social media like the plague, and I'm only here for the folks in my crew that do it.
Yeah.
And you had told me that you were recording this. I see a little recording button in the corner. How are you going to just email it out to us, or is there going to be a Dropbox link?
Yes, I'm going to do both. So I will email everybody who attended the webinar. I'll give you the link, and I'm actually going to post this on the Council 57 website under the resources section too. So I will make all of that available so that, you know, for your folks who didn't make it on the webinar, they'll be able to tune in as well.
Way cool. Thank you.
All right. Okay, so I guess we have time for maybe one more question, and I know everybody probably wants to get home. So, yeah, any other questions? Was there anything I went over that doesn't make any sense? Have any other comments? Let me know. All right. Okay, so with that, thank you for your time. And again, I'm going to be sending this information out to everybody so you can use it for your own local. And I'm also available to work with you in your local to incorporate this into everything and show you how to use this and how to make the best use of that. But everybody have a great evening. If we don't catch you before the end of the year, have happy holidays. And we'll see you in the new year.
Hey, Martin, take care.
Same to you, brother. Same to you.